look to our precious Jesus today, who saves, heals, delivers, and blesses. This is your day for a miracle.
And to Jesus be all the praise. I am so happy today to be with my amazing son-in-law, Michael. I'm in his studio here in Orlando, and I love you.
I love you so much. This is your studio, too.
It's yours. We're going to teach today on recovery. You're going to love it. But, Michael, say hello, a few words, anything.
Yeah, it's just so good to be here, you know. I'm really excited about what you're going to touch on regarding agreement.
Because he already heard it, that's why.
Well, and I believe it's what the Lord's really trying to impart into our lives, our families, our ministries. We're stronger together.
Yeah.
I think I told you a few days ago, I've been coming together with other voices, and now we're seeing stadiums fill again, and the amount of miracles. That's why I was getting so excited a few minutes ago with you as we discussed this prior, because I've seen a miracle increase as I've agreed with other brothers.
What I'm going to talk about with you is the five keys of recovery that are in the Bible. I'm going to show you the five keys that will restore things to you. You know, everybody's lost things in life. And God has given us some amazing keys. If we follow them, we will see restoration, recovery. Because it says David recovered all. Not only did he recover all when he came to Ziklag, he recovered the throne.
Wow.
As a result of these five keys. But one of them, Michael talked about, is agreement.
Yeah.
So now you're seeing what with young people? Like you just came from
Switzerland.
And you saw stadiums packed.
Yes, stadiums. And just in Houston, we had our Jesus Conference Regional. And the Lord spoke to me. Actually, Daniel Kalenda, who we love, and obviously who you know, was sitting in the front row. It was my session. And the Lord said, I prayed for the sick once, and we saw miracles. The Lord said, bring Daniel up, and both of you agree for miracles. And when we did, too many to count.
We're going to do this today. Michael and I are going to come into agreement for you today that your miracle will come,
amen.
Whether it be spiritual, physical, emotional, or financial.
Amen.
There, you're going to see from what I'm going to teach on the power of this thing. So get your Bibles and let's begin. David comes to Ziklag, 1 Samuel 30. Everything is taken away from him, his family, and so on. And the Bible says this. And this is really how I think it all begins. We all get in trouble here. It says, this is verse 4, and David and the people that were with him lifted up their voice and wept until they had no more power to weep. So when you and I begin to lose things, it affects us emotionally, physically. And David's two wives were taken captives and so on. And the Bible says in verse 6, and David was greatly distressed, for the people spake of stoning him. Now, this man was at the point of death. God had promised him the throne, and here these men wanted to kill him, that he helped. That often happens with people. Because the soul of all the people was grieved, every man for his sons and his daughters. So here he is under incredible pressure.
Mm-hmm.
But he knew the keys. He encouraged himself in the Lord his God was the first thing, which is praise. And I want to give you quickly the power of praise.
Yeah.
Okay? So now you already have the notes because we did this for Periscope earlier and for Facebook. By the way, you can join me daily, mostly daily, on Facebook now live. We just did Facebook live. I could not believe the response.
Yeah.
It was like 25,000 people the last time I looked. So you can join me on Facebook live and Periscope Live almost every day.
Yeah, and if they're following you, if you're following Pastor Benny, be sure to turn your notifications on for Facebook.
Yeah.
So that way when he comes on, that notification will come up on your phone and they can watch you right away.
And by the way, all of you watching, this is your day. I'm gonna give you my email in just a little bit so you can send me your prayer request that comes straight to my iPad. Okay, let's continue on the power here we're talking about. Why praise? Because number one, praise is where God lives. The Bible says God dwells in the praise of his people. Psalm 22, verse 3. You can take notes. They're on the screen for you already. Number two, why praise? Because it gives us access. Psalm 100, verse 4. we enter into his courts with praise. Why praise? Because praise changes our garments. That's Isaiah 61:3. He will give us the garments of praise for the spirit of heaviness. Now, what does it mean to change garments? To change garments means that you change the situation you are in.
Wow.
Garments represent, by the way, righteous living or sinful living. But garments also represent change in what's going on with your life. You may be under a heavy cloud. You may be under oppression or bondage. You start praising, that thing breaks.
What is praise, Bob?
Well, okay, I'm glad you've asked me that. Praise follows thanksgiving. Here's the way it goes. Thanksgiving, praise, worship. We thank the Lord for his goodness. We praise him for his greatness. Great is the Lord and greatly to be praised.
Wow.
His greatness. We worship him, why? And this is in the Psalm 95. We worship him for the fact we are the people of his pasture, for his care. We are his flock. But worship is impossible without a revelation of the Holy Spirit revealing God's holiness. I'm going to tell you something that's quite powerful. In Isaiah chapter 6, I'm going to continue quickly on this. By the way, I'm doing two programs that will really, really bless you. In Isaiah 6, you have the angels of glory. Holy, holy, holy. Seraphims, huh? And it says that with two they cover their face. Two wings. Six wings. With two they cover their face, with two they cover their feet, and with two they fly.
Yeah.
If you look it through the Bible, covering face is what? Worship.
Mm-hmm.
Flying is what? Service.
Mm-hmm.
They cover their face with four wings and their feet. Four wings were used for worship, while two wings were used for service, meaning worship is double as important as service.
Yeah, wow.
Because they worshiped with four wings. What did Elijah do when he came to Horeb?
Yeah.
Covered. Why do Jews wear that shawl? It's an act of worship. So, but praise is what brings you into worship, and worship brings you into where God is. But God begins to show up in praise. Enter into his gates with thanksgiving, Psalm 100, into his courts with praise. Now, the minute you begin to praise, God shows up. Then you're allowed access. Then God begins to change your situation on garments. Number four, would you mind reading for me Psalm 50:23? Because here it says very clearly that praise brings deliverance. And I love it when you're with me because I don't have to do all the work.
Keeps you young.
I love it. My favorite. I'm telling you. I love Michael with all my heart. He married my Jessica. I have three grandkids by him. Woo-hoo! I love it. Okay.
50:20. 50.
That's Psalm 50, verse 23.
Yeah. Whoever offers praise glorifies me, and to him who orders his conduct aright
will I show
the salvation of God.
Or deliverance, sozo.
Yeah.
Yeah, same word.
Wow.
In Greek, it's sozo.
Yeah.
But, so when we praise, we're set free. And then, would you mind turning to Psalm 59 and then Psalm 71? In Psalm 59:7, it says praise brings protection into our lives.
Yeah. Indeed.
Psalm 59:17.
Oh, 17.
Yeah.
Okay. To you, O my strength, I will sing praises, for God is my defense.
That's it.
My God of mercy.
Yeah.
You know, I remember the story you told me when the Holy Spirit first touched you, that you used to go out and take a hymnal.
I did. A basic center, yeah.
Yeah. And just worship Jesus.
Yeah.
And then the other day at Lily's wedding, you were walking behind me singing. Yeah, it was. And I said, you're full. Because it's natural, right?
When I carried my mom's casket a few days ago, I was just singing and praising the Lord. And one of my brothers said, be quiet. I said, no, I'm not going to be quiet. This is not the time to sorrow. This is the time to praise.
Yeah.
It was tough, but
sure.
Praise literally releases you from sorrow.
And I used to believe when I was younger that I had to feel a certain way to praise. then I realized that praise is what made me feel the way I
need. Yeah, well, if you have to feel, it's not a sacrifice.
Wow.
Okay, now look at Psalm 71, 6 through 8. So now remember what we just said. Praise protects you, but praise also preserves you.
6 through 8?
Yeah, Psalm 71.
Okay. By you, I have been upheld from my birth. You are he who took me out of my mother's womb.
Preservation. Keep going.
My praise shall be continually of you. I have become as a wonder to many, but you are my strong refuge. Let my mouth be filled with your praise.
Whoa.
And with your glory all the day.
Yeah.
It's an messianic psalm too.
Yeah.
That's the way Jesus lived.
Well, he sings in the church, by the way.
Yeah.
Now look at this one. And this is the sixth result of praise. And David knew, sweet people, David knew the power of this thing. I remember hearing Catherine Kuhlman. She said, if you pray and nothing happens, start praising, it will happen.
Wow.
Because there's sometimes God will not give us anything till we praise him.
Wow.
Absolutely.
Amy talked about that too, or one all of them, she saw demons outside her tent.
The great saints of God always taught on praise, whether it was Derek Prince or Corey or Miss Lee Schlink. Praise is a powerful tool. Because see what praise does, here it says it's a weapon. You know, Satan fears that one. Because in Psalm 149, 6 through 9, it says, let the high praises of God be in their mouth and a two-edged sword in their hand to execute vengeance upon the heathen and to bind their nobles with fetters of iron. Meaning when we praise God, demons are bound.
Thank you, Lord.
Demons are chained.
Thank you, Jesus.
So if there's a devil harassing you, I'm telling you people, start praising. And if you can't praise, play a tape and sing along. That's what sometimes I do.
Yeah.
I just start, like, you know, I take my iPad. I'm gonna show you exactly how I do it. Watch this. Now I'm teaching on this, but I'm gonna show you. Okay? And what a wonderful thing today that we have these amazing tools in our hands.
Yeah.
I was feeling so horrible about a month ago. And I didn't know what to do. I said, okay, Lord, there's only one thing I can do. So I took this same iPad here and I went to my music and I put my music on and I have some of the greatest praise songs. Some of the greatest praise songs. And suddenly I said, okay, Lord, I've had enough of the devil and I've had enough of all this nonsense. And here's what I did. I began praising, guys, with this music. This is one of the greatest.
Yeah, I remember that one.
Yeah. Now, I actually did this, and I said, and I began doing this.
Wow.
I didn't sing. I just did this. That thing began breaking. Now, this is what I did. And then you start singing. The Lord.
And everything changes.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
Everything changes. And then you play songs like, watch this. Now, I'm giving you a little experience here, okay? Because not only am I teaching, why don't you do that?
Yeah.
Play it like in your home. Mm-hmm. It breaks the oppression.
Yeah, it does.
Huh? You want to see my favorite one? My favorite. Guys, I'm showing you some of my... This is my favorite. Now, you stop playing the song, you start crying. Huh? Listen to this. Now, I'm teaching on this, but you gotta just enjoy a second, okay? Listen. Feel it already.
Yeah.
Why don't you lift your hands and just let him. I mean, you feel the presence of the Holy Ghost. That's dear old Abby singing the old beautiful song. Why don't you do it now? Just lift your hands and praise the Savior. Come on. Now you're feeling it right now, aren't you? Aren't you? Yeah. That's all I do. And one of my favorites, when I'm like really down, you almost don't want to change that, you know? It's so precious. This is, sorry I had to stop it. But this is one of my favorites, because I start feeling the anointing of God with this. And it starts doing everything I'm talking about. It's a weapon. Wow. It's an arsenal. High praise. Jesus, listen. Your name is power. One of the greatest.
Jesus, your name
is might.
Jesus, your name will break every stronghold.
Break every stronghold. Why don't you lift your hands and praise Him in your home? Come on. Let's just praise Him. Like right where you are, come on. You're teaching on it? Let's enjoy the moment. Right on, this is your day. Love it. Lift your hands and call His name right there where you are, right? Come on, please. You see the change happen with you, even now. Above any other, Lord. Thank you, Savior. Thank you, Jesus. Whoa, man.
Feel that, the anointing here. Thank you, Jesus. Power, Lord.
Now, you do this. We just played it for minutes ago, and I'm already crying. Don't you feel it?
Oh, yeah.
The power of praise. And God begins to do battle for us. That's the seventh key. Man, I feel the anointing here. Oh. 2 Chronicles 20:22. They began praising the Lord, and the battle changed. Are you facing a battle right now? Just start praising. You know what I love, and I know that this is going to really bless you, and I wasn't planning on doing it, all this, but Bill Gaither, some of the greatest. Just get some of the Bill Gaither tapes. Just this. Listen to this. I mean, you start, and who can be the same? I play these songs. And you start hearing songs like this. Excuse me. You know, that's the power of God. Now, by the way, this is the Billy Graham Music Homecoming CD. I have some of them on my, and I just, so I worship it. Now, listen. I'm almost out of time, can you believe it? Maybe I should leave this and then we'll pray with you right now. Come on, let's believe God with him. I'll continue tomorrow, okay? Maybe I'll do more than two programs. Lord, heal your people. In the name of Jesus, bring healing, bring restoration. Bless each one of them today. Michael and I agree, Lord. We agree for healing, for deliverance, for restoration. In Jesus' name, we rebuke that sickness. In Jesus' mighty name. Somebody's Spanish has been healed. Skin cancer, we command it to go in Jesus' name. God is showing you things.
Yeah, I see a man who has a eczema, skin disorder. It flares up right between your eyes, just above your nose. The Lord's healing that right now.
In fact, it was
very red just a few minutes ago. And it's going away in Jesus' name. Even a woman's stomach is being healed.
Amen, Lord.
Just below the, right on the waistline, you have a deep pain. The Lord is healing you.
Amen.
In Jesus' name. Thank you,
Lord. Somebody, listen to this. George Beverly Shea.
Yeah.
Lord, I rebuke that sinuses I see right now. I rebuke it in Jesus' name. Lady with arthritis getting healed, we rebuke it in Jesus' mighty name. Now listen. Can we just sing it just quick? Come on.
Lord, we love you.
He touched me. I'm loving this today. Just lift your hands and love it. Something always happens when Jesus comes by, saints. Always. There's a lady watching us that's got a problem with your hips. Bad problem with your hips. I'll let you play, Bruce, while we continue. Thank God Bruce is with us today. Look, I'm teaching on the power of praise. Why not show you an example? I mean, when we sang that song, you just felt the anointing, and the garments of praise came, even in this studio,
Jesus.
Things began changing. Tomorrow, I want to continue talking about agreement. We were supposed to do it today, but we just have to wait till tomorrow, okay? Those of you who are partners with my ministry, I'd like to send you the notes of my teaching on the five keys of restoration. All you have to do is simply call the number on the screen. I'll send you my notes free. If you want to give a gift, of course you can. But partners, I'd love to send it to you. If you're not a partner, just become a partner today. Think about $1 a day helping me take the gospel to the world and feeding children around the world and so much more. And I want Michael to talk to you about the importance of giving and why.
Yeah, you know, we're living in the greatest hour.
Talk to
him. You know, Jesus said the harvest is ripe, it's white, it's ready. And then he told us to pray for laborers, that they would go and reap the harvest. I have never, ever seen, Bob, so many people so ready to be saved and healed as I have now. And this ministry, look, if you love our ministry, if you love the ministries of so many others who are out there, I have yet to meet anyone, especially my close friends, who have not been directly impacted by Benny Hinn Ministries. I'm a partner with this ministry. I have been since I was a boy. I want to encourage you, look, there is no greater place to give really what the Lord has given you. Everything we have comes from the Lord. There's nothing greater to do with what the Lord has given you than to sow it into the gospel. You know, I'll never forget when Jesus visited me afresh, maybe in 2007, and all these people came forward to be saved, and the Lord said, "This altar call is an offering unto me." It changed everything. But ultimately, when we preach the gospel, we're giving Jesus what he died for.
Yep.
It's a holy privilege. So there is no greater, more blessed thing to do with what the Lord has given you, with your sustenance, and to put it in to the gospel. And if you do, I guarantee you, the Lord, he becomes a rear guard. He becomes a shepherd in seasons where we need his guidance. I've seen it with Jess and I. The studio we're in is a miracle.
Absolutely.
So I want to encourage you, give to the Lord. Give to this ministry. It is wonderful, wonderful soul.
Thank you for saying that, Michael. Now, listen, I want to pray with you right now for your financial breakthrough. We want to both come into agreement, and tomorrow I'll be teaching on the power of agreement. So, Father, we agree, Michael and I, for the people watching, that every person needing a financial breakthrough,
yes,
that it'll
Lord.
Come, Lord, it'll come quickly. In the next 90 days, Lord, I pray miracles will come from
yes,
everywhere.
Jesus.
Lord, for some of them need it way quicker than that. Do it for your glory and honor, for your majesty. In Jesus' name, we agree with them.
Yes.
For a financial breakthrough, for your glory and honor. And God's people said, amen. Now, listen, you cannot see a miracle without sowing seed. That's just impossible. So there's a number on the screen. You call that number right now and sow a seed. Whatever God puts on your heart, sow it. If it's $100, $50, $20, whatever. You sow that from your heart and watch what God will do with you. Because the highest authority in heaven and earth said, Jesus, the Son of God, give.
Yes.
It shall be given unto you good measure, pressed down, shaken together, running over will men give to your bosom. And right now, we are feeling the anointing. The best time to give is when you feel that anointing.
It's true.
Because the grounds are ready for the seed to be received. So if you are believing God right now for a miracle financially, that number on the screen, you call it right now. And sow your seed and watch what God will do with you. Tomorrow we continue with this amazing teaching. Love you all. Bye-bye.